Okay, how many people tried this at slumber parties growing up? How many girls, or just anybody in general, trying this light as a feather stuff as a board? Yeah, I tried it with friends. Didn't work. Yeah. No, totally doesn't work. Totally doesn't work. What'd they show in this movie? Bullshit. Don't work. Just like the Ouija board, doesn't work.
Lift off. We have a lift off.
Bitches!
Hello! Sorry, as soon as I start, I get that invisible fluff. Hello, welcome to the vlog. It's Friday. Yeah, it's afternoon. I got up I didn't go to sleep till like 3 this morning because, I've had shoulder pain all night. So I stayed up and edited the vlog and, can't see me. I stayed up and edited the vlog, got that done, and then I got it uploaded once I woke up. I woke up again this morning, got it uploaded, and then went back to sleep. My shoulder has just been killing me. I think it's because we have rainy weather. Hopefully, I have you guys sitting on top of our washer in the hallway. But then I have Patrick has clothes hanging here that are drying because, we don't have a dryer. So I'm using this. This is just a tennis ball and an old hospital sock of mine from one of my many hospital trips back in the day. But you can get any sock and take like a... You could do a golf ball, but a tennis ball is better. And you put it in, and so you just hang it over, and then wherever you have a knot, like in your back or your shoulder, you can just roll it out. So I came over here, and I'm like, I can start my vlog while I roll out my shoulder. So yeah, it's talking to one of you guys, hey, in the comments about Foodie Beauty and her Muslim stuff. I was talking to one of you guys about how I learned a lot about the Muslim... like faith and religion and stuff because of Foodie Beauty. And if you guys don't know who Foodie Beauty is, I watch her. You guys seen me show like some of what they call Girl World on here. Foodie Beauty years ago started off as like a mukbanger, but when she would mukbang, she would tell these stories that were really cringe and stuff about like her, hooking up with a homeless guy for like a Whopper and stuff like that. And then during like COVID, she starts streaming her life and streaming herself dating. And this is before Foodie becomes a Muslim woman. And during this time, she gets involved with a guy named Nader, and they call that Crackhead Olympics. And during that time, she was doing crack with Nader. She says this. And she would like take like massive amounts of edibles on her live streams and like green out. She would drive live streaming in blizzards and shit. This is the woman who was like, I want to try McDonald's in America. And so drove to New York during like COVID so she could do this. And during the time that week, there was supposed to be a law changed over where you didn't need to have a test to go back to Canada. And so she goes for the night and then realizes, I don't want to be here. I want to go back to Canada. Fuck America. And so she's trying to get back over the border. And they're like, you need to go get this test that's going to take you 75 hours to get results of, or you can just wait till tomorrow or the next day. And she was even thinking of just paying the $5,000 fine to just cross over the border. So yeah. So about a year ago, after Nader, one of her Beezers, that's what she calls her fans, Foodie Beauty calls her fans Beezers. One of her Beezers inserted themselves into her life and stole Nader from her. I know. Stole a crackhead from her. So Foodie decides to get back at Nader. Nader's from Egypt too. Nader moved. He's a refugee from Egypt. And so he is Muslim, but I think he's not like exactly a practicing Muslim. So one of her things I think was he would sometimes like point out she's not like, a Muslim woman or something. I don't know. So she, I think, thought by marrying another Arab man that and be reverting to being Muslim, that this would somehow get back at Nader. So she meets this guy, Salah. When she turns her Tinder, this is how she says she met him. She goes, she put her Tinder on Global. And within hours, Salah shows up in her DMs. Within that, like, 24-hour window of meeting Salah, who lives in Kuwait, they decide to get married. And she decides to become a Muslim. I'm not kidding. Within 24 hours, she decides, I'm going to start wearing a hijab, and I'm going to become a Muslim woman. So, yeah, within a month of meeting Salah, she's in Kuwait. We were like, is she really going to Kuwait? Because we saw her put the hijab on. We're like, okay, foodie. Maybe, I don't know. We all knew she was becoming Muslim so that she could get married, so she could get back at Nader, right? So she ends up in Kuwait, right? And while she's in Kuwait, it was boring. All she did was sit around and eat. And she would do things like she did take her Shahada. And then tell us, like, how, look, my husband bought me this Quran. And it was a nice Quran. It was in, like, English. Had the Arabic translation. You know, the, like, where you, the English, but you know how to pronunciate it. And then it had the English. And she was like, oh, I'm going to be reading this. Never read it. During Ramadan, I think she broke Ramadan. She filmed going into mosques. That was the other thing that disturbed a lot of people, is that she would film in mosques in Kuwait. And she filmed in a graveyard too, like when they went to go visit Salah's mom for Mother's Day, which is actually illegal in Kuwait. So she was just very rude, and didn't actually practice the religion. People think it was more so she could cover her face and her double chins. If you go over to French Fried Girls, she talks about, she'll call the hijab her, foodie's basically just wearing chin spanx. That's because she's just wanting to cover her face. And actually that she covers more of her face than she has to with the hijab. I don't know anything about all that. I just know that, like, there was one time foodie was actually wearing pants on her head and calling it a hijab. Which, I'm not Muslim, but I think that's kind of, you know. She did it just so she could live stream. She's like, yeah, I had to come on here and live stream. So I just been on my head. It was weird. So, yeah. So, yesterday, what happened in Girl World was that one of her beezers, yet again, decided they would message Salah. And everybody was pretty sure Salah had already cheated on Foodie, because there was this picture that came out of him on a bed with another woman, and it was red, and so they call it the red room, or he's in the red room. And there was just a lot of odd things, you know. And then when they went to Thailand, she was always in the hotel by herself, and he was out doing his walking streams, but he's like in the red light district of Thailand. Yeah. So the other thing too about Foodie is that she never would pray. She never prayed. Like, she would say she was gonna, like, we would hear her. There was one time she was raging at FFG, the one day. Oh, that's the other thing. Foodie Beauty gave away her two pet cats to move to Kuwait. So she has this cat. She had this cat of, like, almost 20 years named BBJ, and was like, well, I fell in love with Salah after a month, so I'm gonna rehome my cats. And when Foodie did not care about really what happened to these cats, because she was going to try and put BBJ down and say it was old age. But then a beezer reaches out and goes, oh, I'll take her. And because Foodie didn't want to have to pay any vet bills, just gives BBJ to whoever reached out in her DMs. Thank God the person who reached out in the DMs was FFG, the reactor I listened to. her sister-in-law. Her sister-in-law pretended to be a Beezer to get BBJ, so BBJ didn't get put down, so Foodie could move to Kuwait. I know. So FFG and her sister-in-law and brother taking Foodie's cat. And Foodie found out about this, and she's raging, and she's raging. And while she's raging about how FFG took her cat, which she willingly gave away, she filmed a video of her giving her cat away. And here's FFG's brother down getting the cat, which she didn't even know, like, that was, you know, her brother. So, it's crazy. So, anyway, so. Okay, my thing overheated, but I think I fixed it. I think the frame rate was too, but technical difficulties. So anyways, so Foodie started raging, and when she was raging, her call to prayer goes off. Like, she's raging about her cat, and come to find out, when FFG took BBJ the cat to the vet, we found out that Foodie hadn't been taking care of BBJ, like she said. BBJ had 5 ingrown toenails that were very painful to pull out. She had mats so bad that vet thought they might have been tumors until they got them off. She had a urinary tract infection that was so bad it got into her kidneys. So BBJ had to go on a special kidney diet. And she had arthritis, which she started getting medicine for. BBJ is now doing great. BBJ has a Gucci collar. FFG got her a Gucci collar, an Hermes blanket. She's living her best life. And Foodie is still mad and upset that her cat is living her best life. Which, one thing that was very interesting to me, and I actually really enjoyed finding out, because I'm a cat person, was that in the Muslim faith, cats are kind of sacred. I really, really enjoy hearing about, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I could be wrong, that one of the prophets of Muhammad didn't want to disturb his cat. His cat was sleeping on his robe or something, and so cut off the thing. So his cat, so yeah. It's doing the blinking thing again. We'll just record until it stops, but yeah, that he didn't want to disturb his cat, so he just cut the sleeve of his robe off so he could go pray and not disturb his cat, which I thought was really nice. So yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out this temperature setting on this camera. I was kind of looking while it was cooling down, and they were saying that I really should still be shooting in 1080p on this, but I want to shoot in 4K, so we'll figure it out. It might be that I have this like little shoe thing on the bottom. I might need to take that off, but yeah. Rolling out my shoulders. So I'm hoping once I get on top of my pain, we can do some flat lay pictures, or like pictures of the product pictures that I gotta take. And then I do gotta do my nails. So hopefully I can finally do my nails. I've been saying forever, I wanna do my nails today, and then I don't do it. So yeah, we got stuff. Oh, I almost forgot. I'm going to link some documentaries. People have done documentaries about Foodie Beauty. So I'm going to link some of those below. So if you guys want to catch up on, it's really like a soap opera, like Girl World. It also involves Amber Lynn, but I mostly follow the Foodie Beauty stuff because this is like a soap opera. So I'm going to link some of those Foodie Beauty documentaries. I know, documentaries about this woman below for you. There's some really good ones out there. So yeah. Hello, so Patrick's home, and we got Red Robin for dinner. I got a kid's meal. I got a Red Robin cheeseburger and the fries, and then I got a side of the Whiskey River barbecue sauce to stick on the burger, and then I did a little ranch too. Yeah, that's my dinner for tonight. Patrick got the Southern Charm burger.
It comes with bacon.
I know. It's like a glazed bacon or something. It's pretty good. So tonight, the movie of your free movie, because there is going to be a free movie, is going to be The Craft.
Such a good movie.
It is a good movie. Let me find my list. Yeah, this afternoon I didn't do anything but sit around and do this and stretch out my arm and use the tennis ball and stuff. And the foam roller, just
It still hurts. Playlists. Let's see. I'm on YouTube. We're on the YouTube. Ah. Where's my... all my playlists. You got a billion playlists where you save a billion things. Where is my... free movie playlist? No. Free Christmas... free movies on my DS. Let's see. I have a bunch of free movies saved, as you can see. Let's see. As I scan, I'm like, oh, that's a good movie. That's a good movie. That's a good movie. Oh, I passed it. There's, we're going to watch The Craft tonight. Ooh. Boogie. Yeah. See, I got a bunch of other movies on there. Resume watching. Restart movie. So this is your free movie, is The Craft. Yeah. I figured while... no, rewind. I hate that when it does that.
We said restart.
I know. I figured while after dinner, well, I'll do my nails and maybe do a little speed. A speed thing for you guys. A little speed thing. Whatever, you know, time lapse, and then I can see if my camera's gonna do that overheat thing. But yeah, that's what's going on tonight. This is a real rockin' Friday night over here, right?
Good time.
We're gonna watch The Craft. I'm gonna paint my nails, probably do a little more editing. I did some editing while I sat around and did this and tried to get my shoulder to like pop and stuff. I did a little editing already because vlogging's so hard, guys. It's just, oh, I got some steam up there, but it's so hard. So hard. So hard. Yeah, it's like, like I said, it's like the lifestyle community has gone dark, you know? Because, you know, Vlogmas is over. Oh my God. We're just too busy shopping and buying Gucci and whatnot, and you know, eating Kobe steaks and shit to you know, do anything else for the month of January. Yeah. Influencers. Okay, how many people tried this at slumber parties growing up? How many girls, or just anybody in general, trying this light as a feather stuff as a board? Yeah. I tried it with friends. Didn't work.
Didn't try it.
Yeah. No. Totally doesn't work. Totally doesn't work. What they show in this movie? Bullshit. Don't work. Just like the Ouija board, doesn't work. Hello, we did the overheat thing again. So I think from what I've read on Canon's forum, we're gonna have to toggle back and forth between 1080p and 4K. But I kind of, you know, have an idea of what I'd want to shoot in 4K versus that, and then I can just render out the footage in 4K. We'll see when I go to edit. But you already know because you're in the future. So got my nails. They're just white. They're just white. So yeah. Hopefully I don't mess them up between now and tomorrow. So yeah. As always, I'm sending everybody lots and lots of love. I'll link the movie below. And as I said, I'm going to link some Foodie Beauty documentaries. So those of you who don't know who she is, if you're brave enough to want to know who she is, you can watch some of those. Yeah. I love you guys. And I hope you have fun doing whatever you're going to do.